Hello guys, here is the first tutorial for the Attractors Designer application for Touch Designer, which allows you to create, design and play in real time with the equation of strange attractors. For this first tutorial, we will take an in-depth look at the interface. This can give you a global idea of what the app can do. I developed the application for my personal use, but I tried to make it as ergonomic as possible. So, after opening the tour file, we have this intro panel where we can access to the basic wiki or a video playlist made with the application or close the window. Let's go. At any time, we can reset all the parameters to their default values in the app menu or individually by clicking on the parameter label with the right mouse button. For example, see I use this slider. If I right click on this label, it returns to their default value. The application is made up of 5 main panels made of tabs and subtabs. Here is the app menu. We can, in the file tab, we can new project, save project as, or keep the application. In the edit tab, we can reset all the parameters to the default values, reset the simulation, and other parameters. In the help tabs, we have a shortcut list, keyboard shortcut list, and also the parameter names list. The list of the parameter names is very important because when we create a parameter in the parameter system, we have to match the name. There will be a special tutorial on the parameters. This is what allows us to animate the attractors in real time and play with them. We go now to the central panel, which is the screen render panel, where we can interact with the 3 mouse button to navigate through the 3D view. And we can use H on the keyboard to reset the view. On each side, we have 4 control panels, and we will start with the one where we can manage the creation of the attractor. The next tutorial will be dedicated to this one. The different tabs are triggers to trigger the transition between 2 attractors. Just change the design a little bit. Okay, it's better. Here, the definition tabs to enter the different constant equation of the attractor. The mathematical syntax must be in GLSL. Here, damping is a global multiplier of constant to represent the shape of the attractor. The time step influences the computation time in the particle system. We can also here save the definition in the file to recall it later. The definition, transformation and notes will be saved in this file. In the transformation tab, it allows making a transformation to change the position and the size of the attractors. Rotation, transformation, size. Okay, we can reset all these parameters or individually by clicking in the label of the parameter. This transformation also affects the emitter by default. We can bypass with the button located below. We can also go beyond the transformation of the attractor. Combination of these parameters make it possible to change the shape of the attractor and create different ones with the same definition. In the Create tab, Here we have the list of attractors and we can create new ones and name them or delete some. On the note tabs, we can put notes to save them in the definition files. We go now to the panel above where there is tabs, particle, inputs, record and browser. The particle tabs is made of subtabs and correspond to the setting of different particle system. A tutorial will also be dedicated to it. I just list the different subtabs. In particle is the different global setting of the particle system. Some system have their own setting as we'll see. In the emitter tab, we can view the emitter. There is a noise. We can change for a plane, point cloud. We can do some transformation. And it changed the shape of the attractors. In the forces tab, we activate the different forces such as wind or turbulence. Here, the time uniform feature will be explained in the particle tutorial, but it allows to use apps time dot second in the equation level. In colors, we can use different operators to give color at the instancing level for the base particle system. The order parameter make it possible to make the attractor act according to the color. Then we have the order system, particle system, like tray system. Billboard system. The flow system is borrowed from the particle GPU and use the optical flow and the fluid system to create movement on the attractor. Auto forces. Just come back to the noise. Okay, like this. It's more fluidy. Here I stop the flow system. And finally, the dust system is a particle subsystem with a curl noise type movement, which is added to the other system. We have a lot of parameters here, like life. And the velocity and other one. The input tab is where we can use different external sources to control the parameter system. This is this guy. He allows to animate the particle system with different parameters. We will see in details later. The different sources are OSC, LeapMotion, SmartBolt device, Ableton Live, and the flow system can be driven by Kinect or LeapMotion as well. SmartBolt device is for my personal use. They are juggling balls with a building motion sensor and Wi-Fi connection. There are two ways to interact on the parameter system with the input in direct mode. This is the direct mode input viewer. I open my iPad interface. And now I can control the parameter system here with my iPad. With the OSC protocol. The second mode is trigger mode, trigger divider. In this case, a cloud divider that divide the trigger every 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, or 64 bits. We can use with the Ableton project. I have a project with the TDA audio analyzer in the master. And if I play, we have all the clock divider data coming in here. We can use this monitor to set each trigger sources with threshold and retrigger delay, and we have this trigger viewer also. We can link with the parameter system for each parameter. Here we have the list of the cloud divider possibilities. And now I link the first parameter with the first trigger. Okay, let's get everything for the input. The record tab is for recording the different composition, movie or image. There is, I cut Ableton Live. Okay. There is an handy option in the image, cache image option, and we can keep the last composition and pulse and continue to working on it and pulse for recording. And finally, the browser tab that opens a database with more than 200 definitions of strange attractors. And choose this one, Thomas Attractor, it's my favorite. And there is equation, constants, and visualization of the attractor selected. Now we are going to the right side. With this panel. In this panel we have everything related to rendering with global setting, light setting, Cino, like scenography, camera sequencer and post effects and outputs parameter. In global tab, we have all the rendering and post rendering setting like ambient occlusion, depth of field, background noise and denoiser. We can access to the camera parameters and the render system parameters. We can find a lot of options. We can access to directly here to the ambient occlusion. And we can set up with this view for better visualization. In the depth of field also we have a depth view map. For set up the depth of field. And in the background, we can set the background with a ramp top. In the light tab, we have the different light sources with shadow, key light, fill light, rim light, and ambient and environment light as well. In the master tab, we can access at all the activation of the light and all the dimmer. In this tab, also, we have a light editor. Where we can set up by mouse the light. Just activate another one. This one. And we can select it. Yeah, and we can change the position of the light. Maybe this one. In the Sino tab, we have the possibility to change the environment and to design it as well. Here, this is a plane, but we can change for a circle. And other option. We can also open a file coming from another software. And also we can visualize it with this viewer. Can also move directly like that. There are other features. But they are more in development, like reflection. And procedural sky. In the camera sequencer tab, we have what concerns the movement of the camera with the position sequencer that react on the audio through the crop divider. For set the different position, we can use the mouse like that. Just init the first position, and I can add. Another one, another one, and I don't know, another one. Just set in manual at 2 seconds, and now I can blend between the different positions, the sequencer. Also, when the sequencer is activated, we can use this option to following the depth of field. In the post effects output tab, we have the possibility of using four effects plugins. Tox plugins. We can use any tox if there is an in and an out. Just activate. There is in the project folder different effects already. Take a bloom for example and activate it. You can access to the parameter directed like that. In the output tab, we have very handy option like post to screen to see with or without effect. I can change the position of the to screen. We can open separate windows. We can have a full view option like that. Can return to the editor. It's very handy because if I take all the of the all the panel have an open viewer. I open this one and I can work like that. It's very optimized. Reset. I have access on this panel. In the options tab, we have the possibility to delete the border of the application. Also, we can delete the display system here or here, the naming of the attractors. And also, we have a fun option, an exhibition mode. Thank you to Electronaut for this tutorial. And he reacts in real time. We can choose image on the frame on the side also, and we have a fun option for the central frame, a sweet spot option, and he put a depth effect on this frame. This is in real time too. Okay. Now we go to the last panel with everything related to the audio analysis and the parameter system. In the player tab, we have the possibilities to open audio folder. And play the different song here. We have here an autoplay function to play the whole playlist or the next song here. Here in the recording parts, we have a playback system which allow to recording the data or audio coming from the analyzer and save it in the file for record it later. It's very optimized because in this case the analyzer is not enabled. Here we have a composition option that allows to choose a given time and automatically the particle system and the audio is derived by this time. It's very handy for doing a composition for Facebook or Instagram, for example. In the audio analyzer. We have all related to audio analysis, and we can enable it or optimize it for a better CPU usage. I just play a song for show you the analysis. We have three possible frequencies here: low, mid and high. We can hear the filtered audio. All the frequencies. For each frequency, we have the possibility to choose the filter. We have roll off, thresholds, of course, gain, and retrigger delay. We have also a pulse view, and here we can see all the frequencies trigger. Let's set the high frequencies, and we have the trigger. With this trigger, there is a clock divider that divides on 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, or 64 bits, and after it, all the data go to the parameter system here for each parameter. Just cut the audio. In the second tab, we have the possibility to change the attractors with the audio. I activate, and now every 4 bass it change the attractor. Can choose mid every 2 or remember. We can also do some presets here. And save it. In the parameter system, there's three modes. The first mode is manual. I just cut the sequencer for a better view. In manual, you can activate the slider for each parameter. Or we have also a LFO option. In this case, the slider becomes the speed. Or we can link also this LFO with the clock divider. Yes, it's linked with the trigger A, it's the base. We have also a random option, and in this case the trigger activate a random values on this parameter. We can visualize the movement of the slider or not for optimization reason. For creating a set of parameter or change the range, we have this. This table, I can add another one, and with the parameter list, I can choose drag, for example, and set the range and default values, and now. If activate here, I have the new parameter creating. I can also see the routing view for the parameter coming out. Okay, that's it. This was the overview of the interface of the Attractor Designer application. Thank you for watching and see you in the next tutorial.